On a side note, while we're on the subject, we also had a hearing at the magistrate's last week, one of my officers, because he cited two individuals that had alcohol and were intoxicated in Triangle Park. The judge threw the charge out because she said, "We do not have signs in the park saying you're not allowed to have alcohol at Bridgeville." So, if they weren't drunk, that was a separate issue, but they were drinking in the park. We're not allowed, by ordinance, you're not allowed to have alcohol in the parks, but she threw it out because there was no sign indicating that. So, we might want to clean up the park ordinance a bit and decide what we want to do, how we want to do it. If we want to make it, you have to purchase a permit to have alcohol in the parks for a special occasion, but if you do that, you should probably not cause a disturbance, not be unruly. Yeah, I don't know, there's several different options, but these are some things we probably should address in some way.
For Triangle Park, you don't have to do anything with the ordinance, you just put signage up. Just like when they have the hours of operation, and in order to cite somebody, you have to have the ordinance, 1, 2, 3 up there, 200 fine, or whatever the case may be.
So, you know, but again, there's been times in the past where we've let people have alcohol in the park as long as they didn't create a problem. Should we have this on a permit basis where when you run a park, you have the option to get a permit for alcohol that can be revoked if you get unruly or misbehave? It might be something worth discussion.
Yeah, I was, Lori and I were talking about it also. Evidently in Scott Township, they have a, like an alcohol permit?
Yeah, even Collier too.
Well, different than here, but South Park.
Yeah, and I have another municipality that has one, and one is working on one right now. And actually, we just reviewed one of their insurance policies, and the fact that you allow that does not bring liability down on you or operate as an exclusion because you're not considered to be serving. And the act of allowing folks to have alcohol in your park is not creating the exclusion on the policy.
Does that refer to a dog bite also?
We were talking about alcohol.
I know that, but you wanted to know about the dog bite.
Whatever.
I think the same would be there. I didn't look at our policy, but in terms of liability, the owner of the dog is responsible for the dog.
Okay.
Yeah.
I mean, is that something we need to obviously sit down?
Well, I'm guilty as charged. I've had communion parties, graduation parties.
Me too.
We've always had a keg down there. No one ever got in trouble. I mean, you watch it, but maybe change the ordinance to allow, probably not allow in Triangle Park, because that's a small park, you know, picnics there.
Yes.
The other parks, I don't know about putting a charge on it, maybe a small $10 or something like that, but put on the permit that you have to be responsible and clean up any extra garbage or stuff like that, but you have to be responsible for it. And if they sign on to that on the permit, I mean, they're taking responsibility. Now, over the years, I've never really heard anything about problems done with people who getting drunk and just cheap. So I don't know if you could help me out with
that. On occasion, people flare up when there's alcohol, but that's been minimal at best. But I think we should have it addressed in some way so that if you do have a permit to have alcohol, you have to behave, you can't be unruly, you have to be 21, you have to follow the rules like everybody else. Just my suggestion. I don't know.
Yeah, I agree with you, really. It's, I mean, there's nothing wrong with having a beer, more or less you've got to keep in control down there. It's a family park. All our parks are basically family parks. And, maybe we can work something out.
Tom's he'll pull some ordinances from other neighboring communities that have.
Yeah, we're just working on one. I'll just send it to Lori to circulate to all you guys. It's basically just a little, and it's nothing expensive. It's just a one-page app that adds an alcohol app to your regular rental app, and then has some rules that go along with it.
As far as the dog or animal situation, is that something we're going to address also? It's like I said, the signs contradict the ordinance.
Yeah, right. We'll look into that. Hit them all with one swoop.
Personally, I don't have problems with, as long as the dog's under, like on a leash and whatnot, but I have seen people with they're trained dogs, like they'll throw the frisbee, they take off and whatnot, stuff like that. And
yeah, there is a leash
So.
You don't have to do anything.
I don't know. Maybe just keep them under control, clean up the mess and the.
It's already here.
If there is a mess.
Put the signs up in triangle. All right.
The signs up in triangle for what?
No drinking.
Oh, not dogs.
Well, that's what Joe said, to have, keep it in triangle part, but not the others, right?
Yeah. Charters and block, cook school.
You're talking about alcohol, right?
Right.
All right. Anything else, Joe?
Nope.
Thank you. That's good.